Hello and welcome to the Imagi. In today's video, we're going to be interviewing Jordan Cole, a singer and actor who played Lawrence in the Broadway musical School of Rock, Gavroche in the National Broadway Tour of Les Mis, and Michael in the first Broadway tour of Finding Neverland. First, can you tell us a little bit about yourself?
Hi, my name is Jordan Cole. Jordan Cole is my stage name. And this little puppy right here is my dog named Maddie. She is 2 years old. And we'll give her a treat for being such a good girl. I am an actor, singer, and musician. I love writing my own music and producing my own music. And I live right outside of New York City in the suburbs.
How did you get into acting?
When I was 7, I took a musical theater class, and I loved it so much. It's where I fit in, and I knew from the second I finished that class that that's what I wanted to do for the rest of my life. That's where I wanted to be. That's what I want in my career.
How do you prepare for a show?
Before shows, I usually like to steam. I like to drink a lot of water, gargle salt water, warm salt water, take lozenges for your voice, warm up, and yeah, that's pretty much it.
Can you describe your average performance day?
For on tour, I would wake up, like to sleep late, I would wake up, eat breakfast, go to lunch, go to tutoring. If it was a matinee, then I would have lunch, go to the show. Afterwards, I would go to tutoring. We have a tutor who tutors us in a small dressing room. So we have a bunch of kids in a small dressing room. But if it was a regular show day, we would have lunch, do school, 4-ish hours, get ready for the show, do the show, and yeah. On Broadway, since I only live like 30 minutes away, I would wake up, go to normal school, come home, eat dinner sometimes, and get ready for the show, drive over to the theater, and do the show.
One more time!
Can you tell us a funny story from backstage?
Yeah, in Finding Neverland, we had a new dresser in a new city, and she didn't put out my shoes for one of the scenes. So we went on to the scene, I went on without any shoes, and one of the cast members came out with my shoes, gave them to me, and we all laughed and we tried to make it look like it was part of the scene, and it was really funny.
It's light, quiet, so fill in all the spaces with the imaginary places. It's so frustrating when no one else sees everything you see.
So for now it is just an illusion, confusion, unless you're someone who believes.
What's the most fun about being on a national tour?
The most fun part was getting to stay in hotels. I love hotels. I get to explore the country, get to eat in different restaurants around the country, explore cities, getting to see famous landmarks. And I made a lot of really good friends. And I just love hanging out with people that I can relate to.
If I could write every single day, I would write all my cares. I'd be leading a different life, a wonderful life,
a magical life. You can do what you want, go where you like, be who you wanna be.
What's the hardest part about being on a national tour?
Was probably in Les Mis being away from my family for long periods of time. Since I had a chaperone come with me, it was hard to leave my family. It was hard to stay away long periods of time with them, but I still had a really good time. But when my mom did come, I missed my dad and my sister and yeah.
You also do voiceover. Can you tell us a little bit about that?
Yeah, I love doing voiceovers. I'm very lucky to have gotten a bunch of things, such as I was in a commercial for Denny's. You might be able to hear my voice on that. If you have an Amazon Alexa, Amazon Echo, whatever you call it, you can always ask it to play Are You Smarter Than a Fifth Grader? If you play the game enough times and you get enough stars, then you might be able to hear my voice on the fourth grade save.
That's a tricky one, but I got it. His name was Cerberus.
Anything you're working on now?
I have been working on something. It's a surprise. I will let you guys know later.
If I can't breathe, then I can't go outside. If I can't go outside, then I can't run. If I can't run, then I definitely can't swim. And soccer's out of the question.
What is a dream role you'd love to play?
I have two dream roles. One of my dream roles is Michael in the maybe revival of Meet More Chill. I also want to play Jack Kelly. I think he's an awesome character in Newsies.
What's one tip you'd give to an aspiring actor?
And a tip I'd give to an aspiring actor is to never give up, always follow your dreams. If you have an audition and you don't get the part, it's not because you're not good. It's because maybe you don't have the right looks that they're looking for. I would tell an aspiring actor that it's going to be hard, but if you try your best, I promise you, you will get to where you want to go.
Mom's getting ready for the white fast summer sale.
Can you tell us one interesting thing that most people might not know about you?
I actually have two things. I love horror movies. I'm obsessed with them. And I also like anime. I love anime. TV shows, movies, books.
Do you plan on continuing professional acting as an adult?
Yes, I do. I would also like to do music, because I like composing music, just the theater in general, making movies I like to do, directing movies, so yeah.
Thank you for allowing us to interview you.
I hope everyone has a great day, and thank you so much for the interview.
Be sure to check out Jordan's social medias. We'll link them down below. And be sure to subscribe to the Imagi, and check out some of our previous videos.
Can I have a voice?